So like this. So now these are the salts which are these are the sulfate salts, etc. Zinc sulfate, iron sulfate, sodium sulfate, magnesium sulfate, copper sulfate. So etc. So there are so many sulfate salts which are soluble. All sulfates are soluble in water, except lead sulfate, copper lead sulfate, calcium sulfate, barium sulfate, and silver sulfate. Okay, right. So this is about the solubility of different salts or bases. See, these are oxides and hydroxides are bases. Okay, oxides, sodium oxides of metal or oxides of hydroxides of metals are bases. Oxides of metals or hydroxides of metals are bases. So that is why heading is salts or bases. So these are only these are bases, and all these are salts. Right. So now this is about the solubility of salts and bases. Now we will discuss about the general methods of preparation of salts. How salts are prepared? The general methods of preparation of salts we will learn now. General methods of preparation of salts. General methods of preparation of salts. See, again these salts, see these general methods of preparation. So again, based on the salts, based on the soluble salts or insoluble salts, the general methods of preparation will vary. Okay, for soluble salts, the methods of preparation, they are different from the preparation of insoluble salts. Okay, insoluble salts. See, for example, these soluble salts are prepared by several methods. So by action of By the action of dilute mineral acids. Okay, dilute mineral acids. On soluble oxides or hydroxides. This is one method. So in this method, how the soluble salts are prepared? By the action of dilute mineral acids on soluble oxides or hydroxides. Another method is by the action of dilute mineral acids. In both the cases, so action of dilute mineral acids on insoluble oxides or insoluble hydroxides or insoluble carbonates. Okay, next, the action of dilute mineral acids by the action of action of dilute mineral acids. So here also again the action of dilute mineral acids on active metals. Okay, so by this method also the soluble salts are prepared. Next method is by direct combination of elements, by synthesis method. What's the meaning of synthesis? Synthesis means already we know, direct combination of elements is said to be, okay, direct combination of elements. So there is no involvement of compounds. So this is another method. So we will learn all these methods with examples one by one. And how insoluble salts are prepared? Insoluble salts are prepared by double decomposition reaction, double displacement, or else double decomposition reaction. Already we know that double decomposition reactions are of two types. What are they? Neutralization reaction and precipitation reaction. So insoluble salts are prepared by double decomposition reaction, particularly precipitation reactions. So this is important. So insoluble salts are prepared by precipitation reactions. Okay, double decomposition reactions are of two types. What are they? One type of double decomposition reactions are said to be precipitation reaction. Another type of double decomposition reactions are said to be neutralization reaction. Okay, right. Next, so the first type of double decomposition reaction, so this is example for first type of double decomposition reaction. Dilute mineral acids on soluble hydroxides, okay, or else insoluble hydroxides. So this is exception, this is an example for neutralization reaction, right. Now the other method of preparation of insoluble salts is by direct combination. Okay, direct combination, also direct synthesis, by synthesis. Even these are not insoluble salts, also are prepared by synthesis method. So here by synthesis method, particularly metals are taken in the powder form. Okay, metals are taken in powder form and it is heated. Okay, now it is heated. The heated metal powder. So it is made to react with sulfur. So what happens? They form sulfide, insoluble sulfides. Okay, all metal salts are, all sulfides are insoluble. Already we learnt all sulfide salts are insoluble except sodium, potassium and ammonia. So we will get what? Insoluble salts. So we will learn all the methods now. Okay, so here general methods of preparation of salts. So depending upon the nature of the salt, the methods will vary. Suppose if the prepared salt is soluble salt, that means the salt after preparation, if it is soluble in water, then such salts are prepared by these methods. Okay, that means soluble salts are prepared by these methods, whereas insoluble salts are prepared by these methods. Okay, so now we will learn these methods one by one. First of all, we learn the preparation of soluble salts. Afterwards, we will learn about the preparation of insoluble salts. So, preparation of soluble salts we will learn. So, which type of salts? general method preparation of soluble salts. Soluble salts, preparation of soluble salts. What is the first method? First method is by the action of dilute mineral acids on soluble oxides and soluble hydroxides. Action of like this mineral acids, dilute mineral acids plus oxides, soluble oxides, dilute mineral acids plus soluble oxides. So what do you get when mineral acid reacts with soluble oxides? We'll get salt. Okay, salt. Which salt will get? Soluble salt. So we are learning of the methods of preparation of soluble salts. Soluble salts and other substance formed is water. Okay, so dilute mineral acids. For example, take nitric acid, dilute nitric acid, soluble oxides. What are soluble oxides? Already we know there are only two oxides which are soluble. What are they? Sodium oxide or potassium oxide. So only sodium oxides and potassium oxide are soluble oxides. So take any soluble oxide. So take sodium oxide, dilute mineral acid, nitric acid. So what do you get? See, the hydrogens from acid, okay, oxygen from oxide, they combine to form water. So for the formation of water, two hydrogens are required. So there is only one hydrogen in HNO3. So that is why we have to take two HNO3 molecules. Every two HNO3 molecules will react with one sodium oxide molecule. Okay, like this. So to form water, two hydrogens, one oxygen will form water, and Na2 and 2 NO3. So it forms NaNO3. So already we learned that all nitrate salts are soluble in water. Here the salt which is formed is sodium nitrate, hence it is a soluble salt. Okay, take another example. Take another dilute mineral acid, sulfuric acid, dilute sulfuric acid. Take soluble oxide means, so there are only two soluble oxides. What are they? Sodium oxide or potassium oxide. Okay, so take sodium oxide. So here oxide, so here actually hydroxide, soluble hydroxides. So NaOH, take NaOH, soluble hydroxide. So which hydroxide is soluble? Sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide or ammonium hydroxide. So here take ammonium hydroxide. What happens? So here hydrogens, OH, as these are hydroxides, see, look here. So in this case, one hydrogen, one OH. So here water will form. So sodium and nitrate, so like this. So mineral acids, dilute mineral acids, upon reaction with soluble hydroxides, they form soluble salts and water. Okay, soluble salts and water. So here these are examples. So what happens? So this is another example. Dilute mineral acid, sulfuric acid, soluble hydroxide, ammonium hydroxide is soluble. So already we know sodium, ammonium and potassium hydroxides are soluble. So this hydroxide is soluble. So what happens? So this ammonia, so there are two hydrogens but only one OH. So two hydrogens requires two OHs. Hence I'll write two here. So every hydrogen will take one OH to form water. So there are two hydrogens and two OH, so two water molecules will form. And ammonium sulfate is the salt formed. Already we know that all all compounds of ammonium, sodium or potassium are soluble in water. So now this is a salt which is soluble salt. Okay. Next, carbonates, hydroxides. So first method is by mineral acids, a reaction of mineral acid with soluble hydroxides. Another method is dilute mineral acids on reaction with soluble carbonates. Okay, see, by mistake, before this concept, I have given as soluble oxides, soluble hydroxides. Actually, it is soluble hydroxides and soluble carbonates. Okay, so remember, so soluble hydroxides and soluble carbonates only should be taken in the first method of preparation. So this is in the first method of preparation. So soluble hydroxides and soluble carbonates will take. Okay, so these are examples for soluble hydroxides, and these are some of the examples dilute mineral acids plus soluble carbonates. So dilute mineral acids, take a same HNO3, soluble carbonate, again take sodium carbonate, because all salts of sodium and sodium, potassium and ammonium, all salts are soluble. So this is also soluble carbonate. So it forms what? So when dilute mineral acids react with soluble carbonate, they form soluble salts plus water. So here also nitric acid, dilute mineral acid, soluble salt, soluble carbonate, sodium carbonate. Okay, so what happens? So here again, remember that when any carbonate is reacted with acid, so what happens? So it forms it liberates carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide gas is liberated. So this is most important thing. So when any carbonate is reacted with acid, so carbon dioxide gas will liberated. Okay, along with carbon dioxide gas, water is also formed. Okay, now what happens? So now from nitric acid, two hydrogens. Actually, nitric acid contains only one hydrogen. For the formation of water, two hydrogens are required. Hence, two hydrogens I need. So for two hydrogens, I have to take two nitric acid. To get two hydrogens, I have to take two nitric acid molecules. So these two hydrogens with one oxygen from this one, so it forms water. And what is left over? Carbon dioxide. So it is liberated as gas. And two sodiums and two nitrates are there. So every sodium will combine with one nitrate, so to form sodium nitrate. So as there are two sodiums and two nitrates, so you'll get two sodium nitrates. Already we know that all nitrates are all soluble. So this is soluble in water. Okay, this is soluble salt, water. Okay, so here what is formed along with this? So carbon dioxide is also formed. Carbon dioxide is also formed along with this. So take another example, ammonium carbonate, it forms what? Ammonium sulfate, this is soluble salt, plus water is formed and carbon dioxide gas is liberated. So look here, these methods. So these methods of preparation is said to be neutralization by method of titration. So this is important. So here, first method is first method is called as neutralization by method of titration. Okay, titration of solution of acid and alkali. Method of titration of solution of acid and alkali. Alkali. So these are all alkalis. Sodium hydroxide is an alkali. Even soluble carbonates are also alkali. They are basic in nature. Even soluble carbonates are also somewhat basic in nature. Okay, this is an acid and alkali. Acid and alkali. So as this is basic in nature, as it is water soluble base, some it exhibits basic nature, hence it is treated as alkali. Okay. Right. So what are the salts prepared in this method? The salts prepared in this method are mainly sodium nitrate and ammonium sulfate, and even potassium nitrate is also prepared. Potassium sulfate is also prepared. Sodium sulfate is also prepared. Ammonium nitrate is also prepared. So particularly, generally by this method, neutralization by method of titration of solution of acid and alkali. So by this method, generally this method is suitable for the preparation of sodium nitrate and ammonium sulfate. Ammonium sulfate preparation and sodium nitrate preparation. So in the preparation of this, particularly these two salts, generally we will use this type of reaction. So these are soluble salts. Right, next method. Second method. What is the second method of preparation? The second method of preparation is insoluble oxides, mineral acids plus dilute mineral acids plus insoluble oxides means insoluble metal oxides, okay, to form soluble salts, okay, along with this water is formed. Okay, so examples, if you see mineral acids, H2SO4, insoluble oxides, iron oxide. Example, iron oxide is insoluble. You may take any, it forms what? So hydrogens will combine with oxygen to form water. And here soluble salt, iron sulfate, FeSO4, it is a soluble salt. Take another example, nitric acid, another mineral acid. Take lead monoxide, it forms what? So hydrogens, oxygen. So one oxygen requires two hydrogens for the formation of water. Hence I will take 2HNO3. So two hydrogens and one oxygen will form water. So what is left over? Two nitrates are left over and one lead is left over. Hence it forms lead nitrate. So these are soluble salts, iron sulfate, lead nitrate. Already we know that all nitrates are soluble and even all sulfates are soluble except barium sulfate, lead sulfate, silver sulfate and calcium sulfate. So all other salts are soluble sulfate salts. So even iron sulfate is soluble salt. Right. Next, another example. So here in the second method, we will take dilute mineral acids. This is another method when reacted with even with insoluble hydroxides also. Even with insoluble hydroxides also, we will get soluble salts plus water. Okay, insoluble hydroxides, insoluble insoluble oxides, insoluble hydroxides, dilute mineral acids. So example, take sulfuric acid, H2SO4, iron hydroxide, take iron hydroxide, it is insoluble hydroxide, except sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide and ammonium hydroxide, all other hydroxides are insoluble. So iron hydroxide is an insoluble. So now this one reacts with this, so forms two hydrogens, two OH groups, two water molecules are formed. So iron sulfate, FeSO4 again, so it is soluble salt. Already we have seen FeSO4 soluble salt. Another example, take nitric acid, lead hydroxide, it is also insoluble salt. So insoluble hydroxide. So these two will react to form lead nitrate. It is a soluble salt and water is formed along with the formation of lead nitrate. So water is formed. Now insoluble oxides, insoluble hydroxides, and even the dilute mineral acids, they may react with even insoluble carbonates. All carbonates are insoluble, already we learnt, except sodium carbonate, potassium carbonate and ammonium carbonate. All other carbonates are insoluble. So dilute mineral acids, when are made to react with insoluble carbonates, you will get soluble salt plus water plus carbon dioxide gas is liberated. So let us take example, dilute mineral acid, sulfuric acid, take iron carbonate, FeCO3, taken twice, sorry, FeCO3, iron carbonate, ferrous carbonate, FeCO3. So what happens, this hydrogen will take oxygens, two hydrogen will take one oxygen, okay, to form water, so one oxygen is lost, so CO2 is left over, so that means CO2 is released in the form of gas, and here iron and sulfate, they form FeSO4, so this is a soluble salt. Okay, another example, nitric acid plus lead carbonate, it forms what? Again, so water and carbon dioxide is liberated, it forms lead nitrate, okay, plus water, plus carbon dioxide gases liberated. So this is soluble salt, so all these are soluble salts. So soluble salts, mainly in all these cases, iron sulfate. So in the second method, so what is the second method of preparation of this one? In second method is by using insoluble oxides or insoluble hydroxides or insoluble carbonates. So here, this method is known as neutralization. This method is known as neutralization of a base or neutralization of carbonate. Okay, so in the previous method soluble oxides or soluble carbonates we have taken. Now insoluble oxides, insoluble carbonates, insoluble hydroxides we have taken. Okay, in the previous case, soluble hydroxides and soluble carbonates we have taken. But here, insoluble hydroxides, insoluble carbonates and insoluble oxides we have taken. So here, this method is known as neutralization of a base or neutralization of carbonates. When carbonates are used, it is said to be neutralization of carbonates. When oxides or hydroxides are used, then it is said to be neutralization of base. Okay, so particularly this second method, it is used preferably it is used for the preparation of iron sulfate and lead nitrate. Okay, iron sulfates and lead nitrate are prepared preferably by this method. Now let us learn the third method of preparation of soluble salts. Third method of preparation of soluble salts. Third method. What is the third method? By the action of dilute mineral acids on active metals. On active metals. What are active metals? So mainly active metals like magnesium, zinc, aluminum, iron, etc. Magnesium, aluminum, zinc, iron, etc. So here, by the action of dilute mineral acids on active metals, so what happens? For example, dilute mineral acid, take an example of dilute mineral acid, sulfuric acid with zinc. So what happens? Zinc will displace hydrogen. So this method is said to be, this method is known as displacement of hydrogen by active metals. So here what happens, this is an active metal, so it will displace hydrogen, and in the place of hydrogen that zinc will come and sit, and hydrogen is displaced, it is removed in the form of gas. So this method is said to be displacement of hydrogen by active metals from acids. Displacement of hydrogen from acids by active metals. Particularly in this method we'll prepare salts like magnesium sulfate, zinc sulfate or zinc chloride, etc. So for example, take dilute HCl plus zinc. Again here what happens, so this hydrogen is replaced by zinc, so this hydrogen is displaced by zinc. So what happens, zinc chloride it forms. So because every zinc requires two hydrogens, one zinc atom requires two hydrogens, so if one zinc atom will come, two hydrogens should leave. So that means two hydrogens will leave in the form of gas. So here two chlorines and two hydrogens are there, so two hydrogens will be liberated in the form of gas H2, and two chlorines will combine with one zinc, it forms zinc chloride. So like this. Next, magnesium sulfuric acid plus magnesium. Again, so magnesium will displace hydrogen, and magnesium will take the place of hydrogen and forms magnesium sulfate, and hydrogen gas is liberated. So now another example, sulfuric acid with iron. Even iron also will displace hydrogen from the acid. So what happens, it forms ferrous sulfate plus hydrogen gas is liberated. So in all these cases hydrogen gas is removed from the acid by these active metals. Another example, HCl, aluminum. What happens? So aluminum, AlCl3 it forms, AlCl3. So every aluminum requires three chlorines. So three chlorines, hydrogen gas will form. So three hydrogens. So it is not possible. So we have to take six hydrogens, two aluminiums. Two L, then we'll get three hydrogens. So now this is the balanced reaction. So like this. So these are all what? These are all soluble salts. These are all soluble salts. So what happens? So here dilute mineral acids, dilute mineral acids, okay, plus active metals, plus active metal, both of them will react to form soluble salt, okay, plus hydrogen gas is liberated. So this is the general equation used for this method, and this method is said to be method of displacement of hydrogen from acids by active metals. So in this method, the salts like zinc sulfate, zinc chloride, magnesium sulfate, iron sulfate, aluminum chloride, so etc., such salts are prepared by this method, third method. Okay, now let us learn about the fourth method of preparation of soluble salts. So what is the fourth method? Fourth method is called as synthesis method. So in synthesis method, what happens? So metals are heated. So metal is heated in chlorine. So in this method, what happens? So metal, in the fourth method of preparation, what is the fourth method of preparation? Synthesis method. It is synthesis method. In synthesis method of preparation of soluble salts, will take metal, heated metal onto this heated metal. So chlorine gas is passed. What happened? This metal will react with chlorine to form metal chloride. So this metal chloride, already we have seen, generally all chloride salts are soluble in water, so except some chlorides like lead chloride, silver chloride, mercurous chloride. So here in this method, what happens? So metal is made to react with a chlorine gas to form metal chloride. So it is soluble salt. Okay. So here metal plus chlorine to form soluble salt, metal chloride. If you take example, so particularly the salts like aluminum salt, iron salt, zinc salt. So metal, aluminum, take aluminum metal and a chlorine gas. So what happens? It forms aluminum chloride, AlCl3. So I have to take three chlorines and two Al's. Okay, two AlCl3. So now iron metal and pass chlorine gas onto the heated iron metal. What happens? The reaction takes place between iron and chlorine to form ferric chloride. So if you balance it, what happens? Three chlorines. So here two, here three, so here two. So this is the balance equation. So this is soluble salt. Okay. Now take another example. Zinc onto the heated zinc. So when chlorine gas is passed, what happens? Zinc will react with chlorine to form zinc chloride. Okay. So like this. So this is the method. This is the this method is called as synthesis method. Here only elements, the substances which are taken, the reacting substances are in elemental form only. So these elemental elements will react to form a compound. Hence this method is said to be synthesis method. Okay, in synthesis method, for the preparation of soluble salts, particularly we take a metal, heated metal, and we send a chlorine gas onto this heated metal. So when chlorine gas is passed over heated metal, so that heated metal will react with chlorine to form their chlorides. So it when aluminium is used, it forms aluminum chloride. When iron is used, it forms iron chloride. When zinc is used, it forms zinc chloride. So mainly these three salts are prepared by this method. Okay, so now we learn about the general methods of preparation of insoluble salts in the next class, in the next video. Right.